Have you ever wondered why the vertex of a quadratic function in the form of f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c is the order pair negative b divided by 2a, comma f of negative b divided by 2a? If you have, this lesson is for you. Recall the graph of a quadratic function is a parabola where if a is positive, the parabola opens up and the vertex is the lowest point on the graph, and if a is negative, the parabola opens down and the vertex is the highest point on the graph, as shown here on the right. And now to begin, let's consider the quadratic formula. In a previous lesson, we proved the quadratic formula by solving the corresponding quadratic equation in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0. This process required completing the square, and the result was the quadratic formula shown below of x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac all divided by 2a, or if we break this up into two parts, we have x equals negative b divided by 2a plus or minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now remember, to find the zeros of f of x equals ax squared plus bx plus c, we set f of x or y equal to 0 and solve for x. And if the zeros are real, then the zeros would also be the x-intercepts of the quadratic function. And now let's go ahead and assume that we have real zeros, and therefore the quadratic function has x-intercepts. So the graph might look something like this, where the x-intercept on the left would be negative b divided by 2a minus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, comma 0. And the x-intercept on the right would be negative b divided by 2a plus the square root of the quantity b squared minus 4ac divided by 2a, comma 0. Notice if we find the midpoint of this green segment where the endpoints are the x-intercepts, it would give us the x-coordinate of the vertex as well as the equation of the axis of symmetry. And recall, to find the midpoint given two ordered pairs, we add the two x-coordinates and divide by 2, and add the two y-coordinates and divide by 2. But to find the x-coordinate of the vertex, we only need the x-coordinate of the midpoint. Let's calculate this on the next slide. So here are the two x-intercepts. The x-values are the zeros. And now to find the x-coordinate of the midpoint of this green segment, where again the endpoints are the two x-intercepts, we add the two x-coordinates and divide by 2. Adding the numerators, notice the square root parts are opposites, and therefore adding the numerators gives us negative 2b divided by 2a, and all this is divided by 2. Simplifying in the numerator, we have negative b divided by a all divided by 2. Recall, dividing by 2 is equivalent to multiplying by 1 half. Negative b divided by 2a times 1 half is negative b divided by 2a. So this is the x-coordinate of the midpoint of this green segment, where the endpoints are the x-intercepts of the parabola. This indicates the x-coordinate of the vertex must be negative b divided by 2a, and the equation of the axis of symmetry must be x equals negative b divided by 2a. And we know to find any y-coordinate of a point on the graph, we simply evaluate the function at a given x value, which is why the y-coordinate of the vertex is simply f of negative b divided by 2a. Hopefully this helps explain why the vertex of any quadratic function is the ordered pair negative b divided by 2a, comma f of negative b divided by 2a. Thank you for watching.